Yo, guys. All right, it's that time of year. Holidays are here. Hope everyone had a really good Thanksgiving.
I thought you ought to know
that. Let's see. So today, no big fancy guests today. We just thought it's the holidays. Everyone's kind of doing family stuff and wanted to just hang out, talk about ciders. I've got a ton of cider sitting here. And here, let me show you real quick. We got all these ciders here we want to let everyone know about because it is happy hour. And I also wanted to take questions and whatever we can do to make these days feel nice. Got a little, that was a little Dean Martin in the background. And let's see. So anyways,
oh, by gosh, by golly,
there's Frank.
It's time for mistletoe and
hug. All right. So yeah, if you guys coming up, pop up some questions. All right, so let me look here. We got Michigan, we got Arizona. I saw Sam. Yo, what's up, Sam? We got Kirksey. What's up? Man, today we're going to have a special guest, though we will have a special guest. And Shama's going to come in and join me in here, and we're going to talk about ciders just because she's way better at describing this stuff better than me. You know, I've got that Riverview, Michigan education and keeping it simple. So, just kidding. Yeah, so she'll be in here in a little bit. So I'm just kind of getting things warmed up. I'll take some questions. I do have some drums here if we need to get into that. It's up to you guys. But, yeah, let's see. Do we do a non-alcoholic cider? That's called apple juice. So, yeah, that's called apple juice. And we are not allowed to sell apple juice. Let me turn this down. We are not allowed to sell and package apple juice, unfortunately. We do get apple juice and turn it into cider. If you guys aren't familiar, just real quick, the process is taking juice, just like wine takes grape juice, and you ferment it, meaning you add yeast to it, and or let it just sit out in the open. There's yeast in the air all around us all the time, and that will get into your grape juice or your apple juice, and it will eat the sugars, and basically yeast will crap out ethanol and carbon dioxide, and that's how we get alcohol in our drinks. There's a great movie I saw on Netflix. I think it was about like how beer saved the world or something. I think it's called that. I saw it a while ago, but it's really interesting, and it talks about that, how the discovery of letting some, you know, some sort of beer elements sit outside and it started fermenting, and then I guess someone was brave enough to drink it and they discovered that it was actually helping people get better because of the maybe it was the probiotics in it, or it was the I don't know, some kind of healing concept inside of the fermentation. Anyways, check it out. It's a neat show. Anyways, I'm here. Let's see. Sorry. Getting distracted. Here's a question. Can you and the boys do a virtual live show like Maynard did with Pussifer? You mean we, meaning Primus, I would assume. And we just worked on a little something, and we'll see, that might come out. We'll see how it comes out. It's a little, I don't know. I'm keeping it secret. I don't know anything about it. You might hear about something soon. Anyways, Shama Alexander joined. I didn't even know she had her own Instagram. Uh-oh. I thought she was going to sign. Oh, she can't sign on under. Yeah, that's right. You can't have multiple people sign on. All right, another question. Well, Shama, are you coming in here or are you going to stay on? You want to join the screen or what's going on? Let me know. Will there be a Sasquatch cider? No plans for that. So, what was your favorite Primus video to shoot? Well, they're always fun, man. Filming or doing movie thing. The movie, what do you call it? Process. Filming process. It's always really fun, for sure. We did a Primus video, Mr. Crinkle, which was all shot in like one take, and there's all this stuff going on, and that was pretty cool. Have to set up our kid with dinner. All right, she's making dinner and then she'll come out, so, and then we'll get into cider. Charles is on here. Yo, Charles. Dude, Charles, we got another wave of coronavirus. You know anything happening? You got any news for us? So Charles is a friend of my friend and now a friend of myself. Goob, I didn't see if Goob joined. Anyways, Charles is a scientist at a pharmaceutical company and he's very knowledgeable about all the virus stuff. And he told us a while back, you know, wear your mask because this is a virus that travels in droplets. It can float in the air too, you know. It can be suspended and just hang there for a little while and move around. So if you wear your mask, probably won't get you. But anyways, Charles, yeah. I saw you're on. You got any info for us? I don't mind popping you on here for a few minutes if you want to come on and let us know what's going on in the science world of all this stuff that we have to decipher. And yeah. So do you have any, here's another one. Do you have any pre-show rituals to get in the zone? Mainly just warming up the muscles. Usually at a show from soundcheck, we might start soundcheck at 5, be done by 6. And then we have a lot of time to kill, so we can get tired and lazy. So yeah, just get the blood moving, warm up the body, that kind of stuff. Will Primus make a Rush tribute album? Probably not an album, but are you setting up?
Yeah, hold on one second.
All right.
I just have to shut the door.
Your
light in the driveway is off. It's pitch dark out there.
Okay. Yeah, let's see. What do we got? So yeah, we're probably not going to do a tribute album. I wouldn't think so. There's been no discussion of that. But we still are booked for this next summer to go out and tour, and we were going to do the Rush Farewell to Kings album live. It's still booked, so that might be happening very soon. So what do we got? Here she is, everyone.
Hi, y'all. It's my pandemic look.
Yeah.
I sit around in yoga pants all day and don't wear any makeup.
Yeah, me too. No makeup.
What's your favorite cider?
All right, so.
Why don't you talk about that right now?
Well, now that you're here, we can.
Your favorite cider, question.
Let's get into, it is. Favorite cider. Good question. Well, let me bring it up here. They're all really good. The other thing is, I do prefer a lot of times, mostly this one, the 7-4. I know it's backwards. The label's backwards, I know. They don't turn the camera around for Instagram.
Why is it called the 7-4, Tim?
So, the 7-4 is a time signature, and being a drummer and a musician, that's what we all use to keep ourselves together when you're playing a song. And that means there are a 4/4 beat means there's four quarter notes per measure. So that would be a 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 7, that's where it gets tricky. It's hard to dance to. And that sounds like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Tell us about your favorite cider. 7. We want to hear more about the 7/4.
So that's the 7/4. It is a bourbon barrel dry. Now, this was aged in bourbon barrel, I believe, for 10 months.
That is the oldest.
Or a year.
That's the oldest aged cider in our production facility.
This one.
The bourbon barrel dry. Yes.
No, this one is the oldest.
They're both the same.
All right. So, and then it's been in the bottles for another 9 months. So this is aging very well. So this is an amazing cider. We will have, so in order for us to ship it to you, we have to get approval from the TTB. They are a government agency that deals with alcohol, tobacco, taxes.
Okay, people are asking about shipping that out. Can you let people know that we will be able to ship it out to most states in the U.S. as of next week?
That's what I'm saying. We have to get the Coca-Cola to make this happen, to ship it to you. Right now, you can come by and you can get it in Washington, if you're in Washington. Come by and grab it, man. This thing is moving. And yes, I like it. It's a 500 milliliter.
Highest selling cider in bottles.
Yeah, I'm sure you guys heard that. So, that is my drink. Should I crack it open to drink it, or do we want to show something else?
Yeah, why don't you tell people what you think about that cider right there that you've got?
Oh, gosh, here it goes.
Right now, we've got a very, very special end of the year bottle blowout.
Oh, do you see this? Hold on, do you see this?
What?
Wanted to give props to Darren for his great customer service at the warehouse. The bourbon barrel aged orange spice was fantastic. It is fantastic.
So Darren is our operations director.
That's this one.
We're going to talk about that in a minute.
Yeah.
Darren is our operations director, and he kind of holds, he's the glue that holds everything at Herbs together. So thank you. We'll pass that on to him.
Yeah. Or maybe this is him. It could be.
Shouldn't sunshine on his own ass.
Yeah. All right. Crack the bourbon barrel. Now you can see how this thing looks once it's beautifully sitting in a special. Did you figure out, are we selling these glasses?
We're not selling those. We don't sell those anymore, but we are selling. I'm going to put these online.
Yeah, it's hard to see.
The color.
Yeah, let me add a little more. You can see the logo in here.
A great Christmas cider, but here's the glasses that we're able to sell online.
Oh,
it's called a tulip.
So there you go. This is a tulip glass. We are offering these for sale. It's got, if you can tell, it's got the HC. This was our logo we had at our tasting room, and we are building our new tasting room where we moved because we closed our other one. And we have it at our production facility now and waiting on permits and waiting for COVID to kind of chill out. And then we will have a spot where you guys can come and hang out with us.
Hopefully, yeah. You know, after COVID.
Yeah.
A. Paulson 247, thank you. The aroma alone is intoxicating. It certainly is. Tim, give some tasting notes on for your palate.
All right. So my palate is pretty lame. Meaning, I get some flavors, but I can't really get into the in-depth flavors of, you know, what time of day it was and how many horses were out in the fields.
Oh, my God. Okay, so what does it taste like?
But this is a bourbon barrel. And now, when we got this barrel, it smelled amazing. And it has captured a lot of the flavors. I get an interesting vanilla.
A lot of people say vanilla.
It's crazy. It's almost as if we added vanilla to it.
And caramel.
Yeah, there is a caramel for sure.
There are notes of caramel. So there's a couple questions about...
Really interesting how that barrel affects it.
Couple questions about ordering in Europe. No, we're not able to do
that.
Yeah,
man, unfortunately...
The liquor laws are really, really tight.
We don't have... Now, listen, it's not impossible. If we were to get an exporter or importer to bring it into your country, that's possible. But it would be really expensive, I would assume. You know?
Well, we could do it, but...
It's doable, but you'd be paying a pretty high price probably for it. And it's worth a high price, that's for sure. Our cider is no joke. When I was down in New Zealand. I was down in Australia. We went to Europe, went to Spain. I was trying ciders. And I would take a drink and I'd be really nervous thinking, oh, man, this is just going to kill our cider. We're not there. Everyone I tried, ours was just as good.
If not better.
And there are some really good ones out there, and I liked them. And ours is definitely can hang with any of those, no problem. And it depends, too, if you are into really farm-type, traditional smelling, tasting like this. Our wild farmhouse has a little bit of funk in it. Some people really dig that. There's this one too, right? The Blue Note has a little bit of a... This is a Blue Note.
That's got a floral aroma and taste to it. It's
floral,
more of a floral.
But I remember it having a little bit of funk to it too.
Not entirely, but yeah.
And this is it. This is the Blue Note. So this is from
Someone
blueberries.
Someone said funk.
Funk.
It's funky butt loving.
Oh. So this is This is from organic blueberries, right?
Those are organic blueberries from Bow Hill.
Bow Hill blueberry. Blow Hill.
Their blueberry farm that's just south of us in Bow, Washington.
Yeah.
Awesome little farm. You can. It's like a U-pick farm also.
And we fermented with the blueberries in it, right? This is not like a concentrate that we add. This is where the blueberries sit in the tank and changes the color of the apple juice.
So it's called co-fermentation. And as opposed to what other cideries do, which is why you don't get a headachy feeling from our ciders or that like funk in your tummy. Funk is a big word for me today. Funky butt loving is loving.
Maybe we should.
But
put
yeah,
some funk
so
on.
You know what? People are asking about. You just picked up the new one that we just launched, I think, right?
The hop cranberry.
The hop cranberry. Do you?
That's
want
a. Yeah, that. The, oh no! That's that one.
The
okay.
The color on this is just incredible. So you guys.
Should I crack this one?
Yeah, we just
all
launched
guys,
this
we're
one.
We're gonna crack this
Don't,
one.
Show the label.
This is it. The so hop cranberry.
It's got cranberry and hops on it. Kind of looks like cooked. Broccoli, but it's hops.
Yeah, the label did not come out the way we hoped. It's a little dull. But look at this. Cranberry and hopped. This is seriously good. It's,
why don't you fill it up to the
it's
top
got
so
a little tartness and a little sweetness. The sugar balances out the
it's
tart.
Actually, you can taste the hops, but they're really subtle.
Yes.
So bring it closer so they can see that. I'm going to post a little video so you guys can see the color of this later. But this is just a beautifully done cider. Delicately balanced between tart and hops that you can't really... It's very unnoticeable at first. And as you drink down, it's just very sessionable, very drinkable cider that you just wouldn't expect. When Chris Weir, our cider maker, said he was going to do a cranberry, I thought, are you kidding me? Like, that's what I associate with, like, yeast infections. That's not, like, the cool thing to do. But he's like, give me a chance to do this. So the reason why we chose to do that was because we were contacted by a really cool organization called Ales for ALS.
Mm-hmm.
ALS, if you've heard of it.
I've got the info up here.
It's a disease that a lot of families are affected by in the United States. And it's for one of our associates that works for us in sales, she had who was a father to her who actually died from ALS. And so she kind of, Kim, is heading up Ciders for ALS out of Spokane. And so we were chosen to be the first cidery to work with them on developing a cider. So what they did is they provided us with some hops And based on the hops that they provided us, we created a cider. Now all of the, there's $10 per case, $10 that gets donated per case that we sell. So if you guys can help us this holiday season support the cause of ALS, this is online right now. It's available for sale in all of the states that we ship to. $10 for each case goes towards Ciders for ALS.
Yep. Go to our website, herbcider.com. We have this available right now, and we can get it out to you, and it's for a good cause, you guys.
Hops are not just for beer, Soya.
Yeah, come on, dude. And we have another hopped one, the Rim Shot. So this one's just the hop cider. Really good. If you're into beer, you'll love this.
Oh, that's our new label,
this
too.
This is the new label for it. And you might see this
label.
One coming out.
Boring.
Sitting out there, but now it's da-da, that. So that's called the Rim Shot.
All of our new labels are live shows. They're all different live shows, so it's kind of cool. We thought it would be fun to bring that back since none of us have been to a live
show.
Yeah,
I told people, like, this is something we used to do back in the old days where people would come and stand and stare at you while you play music. So... And hopefully this next year we'll be back into it, you guys.
So, show them the new double stroke and the new black note.
Yes.
So you guys, the double stroke is
look at
our,
this.
That's our
That's a six-pack of double stroke right here.
Show them up close so they can see the cool
Oh, label. The whole thing is in there.
It's so cool, you
and
guys.
They're
holding a can with a live show on it.
See that?
It's just...
And like I've said before, you guys... We'll ship it straight to your house. You don't even need your pants on.
Oh, God. Here he goes again. Can you grab the black note? So this is our black beer, you guys. We're going to... Okay, so we're going to
Here's the black note. This label didn't come
Monday.
Out.
We're going to do a Cyber Monday on Monday for the cans. Right now, we have a 40% off of existing bottles that need to go before the end of the year. So 40% off on the bottles for right now for Black Friday. Cyber Monday, our cans are going to go on sale. So look out for that, please.
I should be on The Price is Right.
Hey. Oh, yeah. Call Shane. Ask
I know.
Her
I wish Shane was here.
Do you want to pour a blackberry real quick?
Well, do we?
You don't have to. And then...
I've had it on this show many times.
Okay, so real quick...
Let's do the other can real quick. We got... You've seen this before. Just a reminder. Six-pack of the Birdie Juice. I am a fan of golf. And... Our partner came up with the idea we should have a golf cider that you can drink out on the course that helps you play better. So this is it. It's a lemon lime. It is so good. And it's not just for golf. It helps golf, but it helps everything.
Sam loves the Rim Shot. Maybe we can send a little variety pack out to the Fred Green guys.
I know. Fred Green band. Guys in Arizona, those guys, one of my favorite bands. Look them up. All you guys out there, look them up, please.
Peru's in the house. Hey, I graduated from high school in Peru, yeah.
Yeah, Shama graduated high school in what, Lima?
Lima, yeah.
In Lima, Peru.
Bienvenidos. Okay, and then the last one before I need to go into our child.
Shoot.
The next one, before I need to head back in and Tim can do some drumming and answer some questions, you can have some holiday fun.
What's up, Dave?
Tim.
Dave Grant.
Oh, sweet.
We got Vancouver, Canada in the house.
BC! The next one's called our Better Together blend, and I'm going to hand the can to Tim so he can
Yeah, here it is.
Too.
Better Together.
Yeah.
Can you guys hear her okay?
Yeah, they
I
can
think
hear me
you usually
I'm
can.
I'm screaming All right. My balls off. They're fine.
Better Together blend.
Team Lima, I love you too. Okay, so the Better Together, you guys, it's been a really challenging year for everyone, and we wanted to kind of do something that put out a good vibe out there of, like, we're in this together, whether it's about a pandemic or about politics or about wildfires or all of that. Like, we saw people across the country trying to support, even though we are horribly polarized right now, and it's been a really, really traumatic year for a lot of people. So we had this idea of, how about we get together with a couple other cider makers and construct a beautiful high-end cider and put it in a can so that it's accessible to everyone and price it appropriately. So this Better Together blend, which Tim is going to
This is it, right here, six pack.
With his fingers, he's going to do the whole Shane thing. Come on, help me out here. So this is a traditional heritage style cider that Chris Weir, our cider maker, made with European cider apples. There are two other cideries involved in this. So this is a part of the Better Together blend and why we chose to have two hands in a field shaking hands over the front.
Showing the cider. Yeah.
Archibald James and Snowdrift Cider, which are both very high-end, just amazing cideries. If you ever get a chance to taste Archibald James or Snowdrift, absolutely don't pass up the opportunity. So the cider makers all got together and put together this blend. And this we're just releasing this week. It comes out on Wednesday. We're canning it on Wednesday. Everything in this blend is barrel aged. And once you open this cider, you're going to taste something unlike anything that you have tasted in a canned cider before. So don't expect your average sort of mainstream, the cheaper mainstream conventional cider. This is a very high-end cider that we decided to can and make available to everybody. So that's coming out on Wednesday. It'll be on our website. We can send it to pretty much anywhere in the States where our third party vino shipper can send, allows us to send to, which I think is like 35.
About 35 states we're able to get into.
So that's a really cool one that's coming up. And then Tim, if you want to just quickly just flash through, everyone knows what the Black Note and the Double Stroke look like, but the Burgundy Juice is still available.
Okay.
And then just so you know of the spice.
Yeah, the orange spice.
You guys, we put a bourbon barrel spice into a can too, which is a really high-end cider that we put into
a
can.
I'm
going to
show you that again, man.
On Day of the Dead. Good. We only have a couple six packs of this left, so go online, herbcider.com, and grab them if you want them. They went really fast.
Yep.
And the same thing with the cranberry. The cranberry is another short-term special release.
Yes, that's this one, the hopped cranberry. Not many left of this.
Not many.
So this is a good holiday drink, as any of these are. They make great gifts. It's Christmas time coming. Do it soon. And the cool thing is, you go to our site. It says stay informed. Receive news of new releases, events, and tasting room specials. Put in your email address, and let's keep you informed. But what I need, you guys to join. What's up?
Santiago Chile is in the house.
Oh, Chile. I like it down there. We have three clubs, you guys.
Oh, yeah. The next Cider Club is coming out right before Christmas. So if you want to sign yourselves up, this is a great gift. It's just like a wine club.
Wine club.
It's a quarterly shipment, and you have three different clubs.
Three levels. I'm going to go into each one here.
Okay, you can go over those. Yeah. But that's a really great gift. It's like the alternative to wine, a wine club, and much cheaper than a wine club. So
yeah, much cheaper and, lower alcohol. Low to no sugars, so it's a really great gift. There she is.
Bye, guys.
All right, thanks, hon.
Okay.
See you in a little bit. So we've got these clubs, herbcider.com. Shipments sent quarterly, March, June, September, and December. Okay? It's like Christmas, four times a year. You got it. That is it. So we have the first level called the Percussion Club. And 4 6 packs of our foundation cans, single stroke, double stroke, black note, rim shot. Those might change depending on the availability. And when you join, we give you 10% off online purchases, including merchandise and cider. 10% off all tasting room purchases once we get that opened. And that, again, applies to merchandise, cans, bottles, and glass pours. So that's the Percussion Club. It's $40 for each shipment. And that happens four times a year. So that's a pretty good deal. The next level up, if you want to step it up, Herb Cider Rhythm Club, $55. We're gonna give you a little bit more. It's a little bit more to give you that special feeling. We're gonna throw in 3 bottles of a specialty cider selected by me and Chris. Mostly Chris. He tends to kind of put those things together. And you get a better discount, 15% of online purchases, okay? And merchandise and cider as well, you know. Well, cider is obviously, cider is obviously the thing that's going to be bought. If you want to add merchandise on that, 15% off. 15% off the tasting room as well as everything else. Now, if you really want to be the guy that everyone loves at Christmas, the one that people are going to go, wow, that guy is cool, that guy is sexy, that guy is a man. Hey, and let's step it over to the women too. The women can buy these things for their husbands, for their girlfriends, for their parents, men and women. People are going to look at you and go, wow, that guy has some class. That woman has some class. That person has some class. It is the Battery Club Herb Cider. Thank you. Shut up and play your drums. I know, man. I'm trying here. Just give me a minute. The Battery Club, it's $90 for each quarterly shipment. You get 3 bottles of our specialty cider. Okay, these are very high-end ciders you're going to get. You get a 6-pack of each of our cans. Okay, those are not in the bottles. Those are different. These are cans, which is the Birdie Juice, the Black Note, the Double Stroke, Rim Shot. Sometimes we have a seasonal release, and we've got this, you never know, right now we've got this Bourbon Barrel Orange Spice that's available, so you'll get that also, and then you get 20% off online purchases, tasting room purchases, okay? That's called the Battery Club. So if you really, 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 here, get in the Battery Club and have all your wildest dreams come true. It's that simple. Anyways, have all your wildest dreams come true. You don't even need your pants on. Delivered straight to your house. No pants required. And all you do is you just go down, you choose your club, put in your info, payment info. This is all powered by VenoShipper. So I'm not sitting here taking your credit cards, writing them down and going shopping, okay? That is not what's happening. This is all high-end security. VenoShipper, they handle wine and cider all over the country. And they're an excellent organization. I love them. They're really cool. So that's a great thing you can do for the holidays coming up. Now's the time too, because then we will know like what kind of orders we need to get prepped for this holiday season. So that's our club. Go to our website, herbcider.com. Herbcider.com, check out the club. And we've got, I want to show you guys some other bottles we have here. So we've got traditional Bitter Sharp. That's a 5.4. Let me go to here. Let me give you some info on here. Save you guys some time. This is our... So you have bitter sharp apples and bitter sweet apples. They're kind of self-explanatory. And this is a blend of those. We've got... And these are cider specific. These are apples you won't... Oh, they want to hear drums. Oh, God. See? Everyone wants to tell me to shut up. Am I that bad? Come on. It's not that bad. 5.4 cider apples. Not your dessert apples. All right. And let me show you this. I showed you, we got the farmhouse. That's a 3-4. These are time signatures. We got the Malisma. Doesn't that look cool? Look at that. Look at that color. It's another one. I'm gonna show you. Here's the whole note. Foxwell Special Variety, SV. So those are cider apples. Those are apples you will not find in the grocery store, you guys. Now this, the Private Reserve Oak Aged Cider. Look at the special label. Has some texture to it. Well, it's a little wrinkled, but this has been a little bit messed up from something. But yeah, look at that label. That's pretty cool. Anyways, this we initially made. We were doing a thing with Costco locally. We were trying to get it out. But we did that, the Private Reserve, and we still have those available. It's a great 750-ml bottle. You imagine you pull that out and pop it down on a table. People are going to look at you and go, wow, that guy's cool. Or that lady is cool. Stylish. And here we have one of my favorite apples, the Wine Sap. This is a great cider, another 550-ml bottle. It's called the Mezzo Forte. Okay, this is the Wine Sap apple. Really great apple. Go over here. We've got the Double Drag Tap. And this is a Gravenstein apple. Okay. Very nice apple as well. This is a single variety. That's all that's in here is the Gravenstein. Not something you would traditionally go find sitting around your grocery store. We've got the Forte. Here's another cider specific apple, the Golden Russet. Okay. I'm telling you, you show up at an event. Well, it's going to be a little hard this year, but you send that to people, they're great gifts. So I'd be pretty thrilled to get this stuff. So go on to herbcider.com. You can order this stuff and we'll ship it right out to you. We've got a fleet of UPS trucks just waiting. So, but yeah, we were doing the Private Reserve. We were doing this thing with Costco here in Bellingham. We were going to test it to see how it does. That's kind of how they work. And we took it out because they're not set up for cider. I know cider is a kind of a new-ish item in the alcohol world. And a lot of places just aren't set up for it. Grocery stores have sections. It's growing, slowly growing. But if you notice, beer is really taking over. And we're trying to get in there. And the Private Reserve, we were trying to get into Costco, but we took it out because we were sitting at the bottom of a shelf on the floor next to a sack of potatoes. So Costco just wasn't ready to be selling cider. Shama's saying there, you guys, you see, we have merchandise on the website as well. Like I'm wearing one of these cool hats. Look at that. And here's another one. See, look at that one. Got a couple colors, super high quality. I do like these a lot. We had some earlier hats that were kind of like trucker hats that were, yeah, they were okay, but these are super badass. And they've got this cool like rubber logo on top, really great. We got our buddy AO designed these things and got it all together. So thanks AO. Go on the website, man. We got some merch. The website is how we can get this stuff to you. All right. Oh, yeah, the beanie. I see someone there is asking about the beanie. Oh, Kirksey, you need some stickers for your race car? Shoot, I think we have stickers. We'll have to see. I don't know, man. Dude, you should just put a t-shirt on your antenna and race. You'd create a whole new style. Yeah, we need to ship stickers out. And maybe you can tell Chris we should get that going. Look at this beanie, guys. I know everyone on the East Coast, this is going to be, well, most places out there that gets really cold. Look at that. I don't know. Oh, wait. Is that GQ texting me right now? Oh, GQ. No, I don't have time to do their cover. Sorry, I'm busy. Anyways, drums. All right. What do you guys want to hear? You want me to play some beats for you? Show you how I did some stuff? We can do that. A radio antenna on your race car. Tie a t-shirt around it. That's what I mean, Kirksey. Kirksey builds race cars. He worked at Ford, and his dad worked at Ford. When we were kids, we used to practice in his garage. And after practice, his dad would make him do oil changes for all of his dad's buddies. And that's how he learned how to work on cars. I wish I had paid attention, man, because I know nothing. Yeah, go get that beanie, you guys. What can we play? What can we play? There's some drums. Should we do something? Let me see. Oh, God. I don't want to hear this that loud. I'm going to play Rudolph Hat the Red-Nosed Reindeer. That's what's playing in my ears right now. To play, I got Frank Sinatra in my headphones right now. Yeah, that drum pattern was in a Frank Sinatra song, actually. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. How about if I show you guys the grapevine groove? Electric grapevine. You kind of increase the tension a little bit. That's how you play the grapevine. These are just to keep it a little quieter. I'm getting old. I don't want to hear loud stuff all the time. Sorry, I'm all tangled up here. How was that? Spaghetti. Oh, yeah, let me do some spaghetti for you. Spaghetti Western. Be sure and go get that record online somewhere. It's off of Frizzle Fry. Yeah. my gosh, it's hard to play. I've got, here, you can hear what's going on in my ears. Frank Sinatra, while I'm playing spaghetti inside my headphones here. I don't know. Why did I do that? I don't know. All right, I'm turning that off. Do we need to hear any other drums, you guys? Sergeant Baker? That has some very interesting drum parts for sure. It kind of, there's a part, but it kind of changes. Like when I did it on the record, I was doing a lot more... I'll play it how I play it now. It's kind of similar, but a little bit more organized in a sense. Hard without the music. That's how that happens. That's the basic groove of it. And, whew. Oh, you want to see the My Name is Mud groove? All right, what we got? 10 minutes left? Hold on, I need some of this special cider. Let me show you the My Name is Mud groove. Oh, let me see. Can I even... I don't know that I could lip sync it. Or I mean, let me see. You probably wouldn't be able to hear it anyways. Here we go. Let's see. Can you guys hear that? That's mud. Here's how I do the ending. One hand over here, usually on a real deep tom. So it goes right hand, left foot, right foot. Simple. Pretty straight ahead. Ah, yeah, that was mud. Mr. Know-It-All. Oh God, let me see. Yeah, I'll do Mr. Know-It-All. That's a pretty good double bass groove. My name is Mud, or what was that? Mr. Know-It-All. All right, yeah. So we got a few minutes left. You guys, so it is Thanksgiving. We need to say thanks to all you guys for supporting us and supporting Primus, supporting the Cider, supporting Claypool Cellars. He's got his wine. You guys check that out if you're into wine. I know you probably heard about Caduceus. Go check Maynard's wine out. It's really cool. Really good stuff. And yeah, thank you so much for all your support. You know, these times are tough. I hope everyone didn't have to have any issues with COVID. You know, it's not fun. And if you lost anybody, which we've heard of a few people who've lost family members, and that sucks. So we're sorry about that. And cheers to all you guys. This is happy hour. I know there's still a lot of stuff happening out there, but you know, we're working towards making the change, right? So everybody be cool out there. And I heard a really great thing. I might have mentioned this before, but I heard a quote. A guy said it changed his life. And I tend to kind of remember that all the time. Whenever you meet somebody, just know that they are going through struggles. They're having, everybody you meet is having some struggles in life with everything. So don't think that everyone's always a dick, because sometimes they're in a bad mood, or they might be racing to the hospital. Who knows? But yeah, and it's cool for this. We'll be able to get in touch with old friends. Yeah, like Brian's saying, thankful to have long distance friends. Yeah, a lot of these guys from my old days in Michigan. And now I see them on here. It's really cool. There's Sam. Stay safe, you guys. Cheers. Thanks, Sam. Sam's Fred Green. You guys check it out. Oh, also, I think my friend Goob has his songs up on, what is it? I think on, is it through Facebook? Boyd McConnell. Check it out. I know he's a guitar player. He's got a bunch of his tunes up that you guys can support. The Starving Musicians. And, yeah. Lots of people out there making music and stuff. But check out, we've got some good ciders to help you create some good music out there and spread the love, you know? Let's see. Going to buy the last Superpower Man. Uh-oh, someone's invading my space. Who's here?
Oh, I was just jumping in real quick. Some people had asked about the jacket, so that's going to be available like this upcoming week. Check it out. We have a men's and a women's version.
Oh, so this is my golf jacket.
Oh yeah. So not. It's not exactly like this, but it's a. It's pretty much the same. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. This is
oh,
exactly.
We're gonna sell this?
Oh, okay, so this cool. is like a downfilled. That's what you guys were seeing earlier.
This thing is great. This is great.
There's a men's version and a women's version.
Yes.
So.
See that? It's got like the quilted look, and it's got down. I think it's down.
It's a down.
Inside.
Yeah.
It's really nice, really warm. All right, 3 minutes left. Shama was here.
Thank you, guys.
Informing all you guys.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, thanks for all your support. Hope you guys have a good holidays. Get through this COVID stuff.
I got dinner ready for you.
Oh, man, I get to go eat. Nice. All right, let's see. There's a question. Can we hear the album now? Well, you'll have to at some concerts. Yeah, we haven't played some of those songs. There's some good ones on there, I thought. But all right, be on the lookout, you guys. Soon. Look out for Primus something popping into the world here in a minute. Keep an eye out. It's going to be interesting. All right. You guys, spread the word, too, about the Instagram. And we do have a YouTube channel, too. I Instagram made it harder. They used to make it so it was easy to download this stuff. So now it's way harder to download it so that I can put it up on YouTube. So, but we do have a YouTube channel. Chris and I are going to get together and do, like, some serious cider talking, reviews, all that kind of stuff soon. But, yeah. Check out the cider. Go to herbcider.com, man. See if we can ship to your state. And if so, give us a little support. You won't be disappointed. And we've got the clubs, too. So, and sign up and get the emails. At least we can let you know what's happening. I don't even know when the last one we sent out was, so we've got to get on that. All right, man. You guys take care. Cheers. Thanks for coming out. Appreciate it. Really do. And hopefully I'll see you guys sometime when we're on the road. We can hang out. All right, y'all. Take care.